Hi friends, most of you have done your preliminary examination comparatively better. Many of you are expecting a positive result, right? If this is the case, we thought of making a very short video answering most of your FAQs, frequently asked questions. So in this regard, two popular questions always comes. Number one, what one serious candidate has to do till this preliminary examination result comes in? And number two, though it is unfortunate, but it is still rational. The second popular question people generally ask, that what one has to do if at all if they are not qualifying this preliminary examination. So both we'll answer in a sequential fashion. Number one, if I start answering the very first question, what a serious candidate or a very good candidate has to do in this intermediate period, that is after the preliminary examination and before your preliminary examination result comes in. See, if you strongly believe that you have done reasonably good in preliminary examination, still if you strongly believe that you can qualify this preliminary examination, you can get more marks, or you are getting more marks than the so-called cutoff, right? Or even for the people who are almost believe that they are something like a cat on the wall, right? It may or may not happen. I strongly believe that you should start your preparation, or you should have already started your preparation, right? Not less than 10 hours a day you should devote studying the 7 papers of mains examination. Optional subject and GS, equal importance has to be given. If you ask me personally, the return on investment for optional subject is very, very high than that of GS. So my priority goes in this fashion: optional subject, maximum priority, maximum time, followed by essay and ethics, because normally people do not consider these papers as an individual subject. But still, when I talk about the mark distribution, essay is for 250 marks, and of course ethics is also for 250 marks. You have to concentrate on these papers. They are highly rewarding in nature. Then of course comes the last 3 papers, what you call as GS 1, 2 and 3. You should have already started your preparation, right? Equal concentration on option and GS has to be given. And what is the best way of preparing at this segment? One popular choice is always there: you better get yourself enrolled in any good test series across India, anywhere, right? In this regard, I would also like to bring one piece of information. Officers IAS Academy has also brought in a test series, and a better piece of information in this test series, this is completely free of cost. And not only for the students of officers, even if you are not the students of officers, if you are an outsider, the offline test series program is completely free for you. You may utilize this opportunity. And we are just almost trying to cover all the aspects of the mains examination. This may also include your optional test series and essay writing. Right. Now coming to the second part, which is the most pivotal area of this video, right? What one should do. For example, if you consider yourself a serious candidate, but still, anyhow, unfortunately, if you are not able to qualify this time preliminary examination, what one should do? And you please understand that every individual may not qualify this examination in the very first attempt itself, right? But still, you have to sustain this race. If not this time, it may be next time, right? You have to sustain this race, right? If at all, unfortunately, if you are not able to qualify this preliminary examination, what one should do most of the time? Even last year, we have encountered this situation. Most of our deserving candidates, very good candidates, serious candidates, they did not qualify the preliminary examination last year. Technically, there was a reason, because last year the number of seats or the number of vacancy in UPSC was substantially less than the other years. So that's the reason the number of people who are writing the mains examination itself got reduced, right? Now we have answered it, because very serious candidate, if at all if they are not qualifying the preliminary examination, again till the month of January you happen to experience a very large gap. This gap is not good for your preparation, because somewhere around 5 months you lose it. Only in the month of January, what happens, generally people start preparing for preliminary examination again. So we thought that this issue has to be addressed. Normally we say necessity is the mother of invention. So accordingly we thought that this serious candidate should not be left behind in this gloomy and dark forest. It means they have to guide it well, right? So answer for that issue came up with a model called as Steeplechase. So we have devised a program, and this program is now very popularly called as Steeplechase. If you ask me what is the objective of Steeplechase, of course, Steeplechase will enhance your preparation. Steeplechase will keep you in this competitive race, and of course, a Steeplechase will play a pivotal role in your success. But still, when I talk about the components of Steeplechase, what exactly the Steeplechase almost results in a candidate, or what exactly is the advantage of the Steeplechase, let me tell you. One, Steeplechase, we have just kept it in mind, the Steeplechase we have designed in such a fashion that where a student will be exposed to the syllabus, right? At least GS 1, 2 and 3, the detailed syllabus peoples normally, or the students will normally get exposed to it. Each and every line of the syllabus, we take it, we'll almost make the student understand that what part of the syllabus or what exactly the inherent meaning of the syllabus is all about. Every word of the syllabus, we almost make the student to decode it. It means by the end of this program Steeplechase, one becomes expert in analyzing the syllabus. Now, understanding the syllabus or analyzing the syllabus alone will not fetch you a result, right? You have to study. Steeplechase also makes you to study, right? Now, how exactly, what is a simple strategy what we are almost employing in Steeplechase? Let me tell you, sir. We are making you to study, and this is almost reinforced by very effective test series program. And when I talk about this test series, every third day we have a test. Whenever I say every third day I have a test for another somewhere around 7-8 months, every third day I have a test, it appears as though it is mammoth in front of you. No, not at all. Imagine that you are writing a test once a week, accepted. But the same one test a week, 3 hours test I am writing every week. Instead, what we are doing in Steeplechase, we are almost dividing the syllabus, we are dividing the time, and the same test what you take it at the end of every week, we are just splitting the syllabus, we are just splitting the time, and half the test or half of the test or so called say 1.5 hours test I'll be taking at the end of third day, and another 1.5 hours test I'll be taking at the end of the another third day. The purpose why exactly we are breaking the test and keeping into two fragments is very simple. Because most of us have a tendency, whenever I talk about a test, whenever we just give the syllabus for the test, tendency of the students normally we find that only 1 or 2 days they study, they write the test. But the same test, if I am just breaking into two, if I am just keeping it once in every 3 days, syllabus is same. The energy you almost invest is going to be same, but at least here I have an advantage where for one test I'll be reading for 2 days and another test I'll be reading for 2 days. So normally, instead of you reading for 2 days, we are making you to read at least for 4 days. This is what the advantage. And one more thing, always we strongly believe that small is beautiful. Smaller is the syllabus, lesser is the almost the amount or the quantum of the syllabus, very efficiently you can read, right? That is another advantage, right? So that's the justification what we have for having a test, that too not a full test, half a test at end of every third day. And very strictly we are implementing this, that in a week, given week, that is in 7 days, we advise you to read or study only for 6 days. 1 day compulsory rest has to be taken. Mind also needs rest. So if you understand that mind needs rest, 7th day you will not work and you should not work. If you are working on 7th day, 110%, 8th day will be inefficient. So make it as a habit, right? Only 6 days a week you work, 1 day compulsory you take rest. Both body and mind needs rest. As I said, one, the objective of Steeplechase will make you to understand the syllabus. Number two, right, it makes you to read. At least you read 4 days a day. Sorry, excuse me, 4 days a week. And number three, what is very important, writing practice. Entire GS, every word of the syllabus, right, you would have written some questions on it. And we ourselves have framed, we have decoded the syllabus and given in such a way that each and every sentence of the syllabus, we have taken it, we have just decoded it. Likely topics of that syllabus is also given to you. And in test, 60% of the question will be from the decoded part and the likely topics or the topics to be focused, and 40% will be based on the inherent meaning of the syllabus. So it means both the dynamic and static part, people almost they prepare for it. And another good thing about Steeplechase, in the sense, very beautifully we have integrated both mains and preliminary examination. So how we have devised this exam or Steeplechase program, once we cover the syllabus of mains examination of a particular subject, say for example polity, we are covering the syllabus of polity, or if not, starting from GS1, if I just start having a test, if I have a schedule based on history, after completing mains part of history, immediately we will be taking that preliminary aspect of history. The advantage is very simple. The content what you read for both this examination is more or less same. But what is different is the approach. So the same content, we are making the student to analyze, to write answer in both the format. So initially he will be almost concentrating, he will be having an orientation of preparation based on mains examination. Right, once this particular syllabus is over that week itself, right, we'll be immediately taking a test in a preliminary fashion. So the content, the same content, you will master it up, right, with changing the orientation or fluctuating between mains and prelims. So you will not have a break between this mains and prelims. So any given examination, any given moment, you will be in a position to take it, handle it. This is another advantage. So as I said, Steeplechase makes you to understand the syllabus. Steeplechase makes you to read, makes you to study at least 4 days a week. Steeplechase reinforces your writing practice. So writing, be it writing mains or preliminary examination, will not be a problem. And both this mains and prelims is beautifully integrated. So from the day of the result, say for example Steeplechase program may start 1 week after the result, 1 week after the result, and we are very serious that a serious candidate should not be missed out. And as already we said, for Officers IAS Academy students, current batch students, Steeplechase will be completely free. But please ensure that it is free, but it is a very serious program. Make use of it, make use of it, and harness the complete potential of this program. Till the month of January, almost maximum part of the syllabus, both for prelims and mains, will be covering it. Right. From then, we'll be concentrating on strategy classes. We have this sharpshooter classes, and after every test, or just because it is a half test, after every two half tests, that is one full test, we'll be having a detailed discussion about both mains as well as prelims examination. Sharpshooter class or the prelims strategy classes is also part of this Steeplechase program, and of course current affairs is also included in this Steeplechase program itself. If you are taking this Steeplechase program very seriously, I don't think that at least the next prelims or the mains will be a challenge for you. Right, crossing the hurdle called as prelims and of course getting a very decent score in mains should be very normally or ordinarily possible. But only thing is that I insist, if at all if you are taking a Steeplechase, take it very seriously. This model is completely a tailor-made model for you students. Make use of it. Enjoy the benefit of it. I wish you all the best for your future endeavor. Thank you.